Now let's talk about snippets. A snippet is basically a fragment of HTML that can contain text, images, or even placeholders that can be affected by scripts. In order to create a snippet, all you need to do is to select something in your template, then go to the Edit menu and click on Copy to Snippet. What this does is create a new snippet that has the contents that you had selected. A snippet can be edited in the same way that you edit a print template. You can change text in it, you can add different styles, and you can add images and placeholders. So just dragging a field into your snippet does the same thing as dragging it into your template. The only thing is, there's no preview mode in snippets, so we have to add it into the template in order to see that these placeholders do work. And drag the snippet onto the print template. There's basically not a big change in how this will react. You can still edit the snippet directly here. So if you delete text, it will actually also delete it in the snippet. Now, the cool thing about snippets is that they are shared between contexts. So if I hop into my HTML email context, I can simply add the snippet directly onto it. Now, the even cooler part is when you have a snippet, even if it's shared between more than one context, changing the snippet in any context changes it for the other. So if I delete something from the snippet here, and I go back into my print section, it's gone also. Now, what about styling? Well, as you may have realized, inside of the print context and the email context, the text is a little bit different because the styling for the email context does affect the snippet itself. And of course, we can go into preview mode and verify that all of the placeholders inside of the snippets are indeed modified and affected by the scripts. Okay, now what about if you already have an external snippet and you want to import it into design? Well, that's easy as 1, 2, 3. First, you add the resources relevant to the snippet, such as images or style sheets, inside of the appropriate locations in your template. Then you add the snippet into the snippets folder. And then you add the snippet to your template. And that's pretty much it for snippets. Before I let you go to the next animation though, I want to show you a small cool trick that will give you a hint of the sort of advanced things that we can do that you will see in the advanced version of this course. At the top of this letter, there is a small contact information. If I hop into design mode, I can see that it's actually just a placeholder called sender. The way that the sender is printed is that it actually looks inside of the sender contact snippet using a special script. Now, pay little attention to the script format. The only thing you need to know is that it gets the brand field from the record, and then it loads the snippet, but only getting that specific selector or the specific element named after that brand. And indeed, if we look inside of the sender contact, there are three different elements here, three different divs, and inside of them, there's only the contact information for a specific brand. And each of these divs have the specific ID. So it's a cool trick that you'll see in the advanced course of Planet Press Connect.